Welcome to this week's edition of Outdoors Online, a weekly webcast produced by the North Dakota Game and Fish Department. I'm your host, Mike Anderson. My guest this week is outreach biologist Greg Gullickson. Greg, State Fair time again. We're at the Conservation Outdoor Skills Park here in Minot. How long has Game and Fish had a presence at the State Fair?
We've been with the North Dakota State Fair and had a good working relationship for over 25 years now, and it's a great area nestled right in the middle of the State Fairgrounds. You know, we're just gearing up already to get ready for the 2019 State Fair. And you know, one of the highlights of the area, besides all of the outdoor education that we do, is we have shade out here. We have grass, we have picnic tables. So when you get your corn dog, when you get your fairway food, come in and enjoy some shade. The best thing about our area out here at the State Fair is the price. Everything out here is free.
Okay, let's go through some of the buildings and things we have to offer over here.
Yeah, we offer a chance to visit with a game and fish biologist, a game and fish employee at our information centers. And then we also have, you know, probably the highlight would be our fishing dock. And boy, it's stocked full of fighting game fish.
Yeah, we talked about that a little bit. Some more diversity this year.
Absolutely. We have bluegill, we have perch, we have trout, we have channel catfish, and even a couple bullheads in the mix out there. But you know, there's enough fish in there to make sure that your bobber is going to be bouncing. You know, and this area is not just open during the State Fair, the fishery side of it. And already this summer, there's been a lot of happy kids with smiles on their faces because that bobber's bouncing and they're catching some fish. So we're looking forward to a good time in the fisheries area. We have live aquarium displays, we have mounted fish, knot tying, pretty much anything that you need to learn to be able to be an angler in North Dakota.
And there's a hunter education area where kids actually get a chance to shoot pellet guns.
Yeah, that's right. Our hunter safety division offers a shooting area where you can actually, they run you through a mini hunter education course, teaching you about different firearms, how they operate, how to make a sight picture. Safety is number one. And then at the end, you actually get to shoot a pellet gun, which is something that's interesting. And that's for people of all ages. There was a lady a couple of years ago in her 90s that wanted to make sure she could still plank that target, and she could. She left the hunter ed area or the rifle range with a big smile on her face.
And it's a safe area.
It absolutely. We haven't had an incident anywhere on our fairgrounds.
Okay, let's move into archery.
Yeah, archery, boy, is that growing in popularity with the National Archery in the Schools program. That's certainly helping to boost that as well. But with more opportunities and more people taking advantage of archery, it's a good area for people to be introduced to archery for the first time, or to maybe hone their skills a little bit, and that's staffed with archery experts as well.
There's a fur bear education area also.
Yeah, you know, learning about fur bears, learning about predator management, and learning about trapping and all of our mammals that we have in North Dakota, specifically our fur bears. It's a great area to have some hands-on education.
And there's also something new this year that we started last year, really, but it kind of bloomed this year. That's a pollinator garden.
It is, yeah. Last year we had just started with our pollinator plot, and boy, definitely already getting some high use from a lot of insects that really help the environment in North Dakota and make sure that things are progressing forward. And you know, with our pollinator plots, you know, that's a main source of food for a lot of our young wildlife that are just starting to develop right now.
And we have some new updates to our buildings this year.
Yeah, we renovated much of the area this year, just updating the infrastructure that we have out here, making it a little bit more maintenance-free. You know, like the Game and Fish, a lot of these buildings have been here since the early 90s, and we really had just kind of been patching it along, but now we have a nice, fresh-looking place.
And this area wouldn't be possible without the help from the North Dakota State Fair.
Absolutely. We've had, since day one, we've had an excellent partnership with the North Dakota State Fair, from the directors to the staff. And you know, the other thing is, this area just isn't operating the 9 days of the fair. It's used by many wildlife clubs, outings out here. It's just an area that's used 365 days out of the year.
And we should give some credit to our fisheries division too.
Absolutely. You know, to keep that pond stocked full of those fighting game fish, hats off to our fisheries crews for all they do.
State fair dates.
Yeah, Friday, July 19th through Saturday, July 27th. We're open every day during the fair. Again, our area is free. Our hours of operation are from 1 to 7.
A lot of good information, Greg. Thank you.
Like Greg just mentioned, the North Dakota State Fair runs from Friday, July 19th through Saturday, July 27th. And the hours at the Conservation and Outdoor Skills Park are from 1 p.m. to 7 p.m. daily.
For outreach biologist Greg Gullickson and the rest of the staff here at the Game and Fish Department, thanks for joining us for this week's Outdoors Online. We'll see you again next week.